To our concerts before, you're not going to be used to me coming out and talking beforehand, but this concert is obviously a little bit different than things that we've done in the past, and it has been 18 months since we've been able to be on stage and make some music, so I wanted to just come out a little bit beforehand and welcome you very specially, family and friends of our singers. Thank you for being open to our seating mandates and the masks and all that sort of stuff. I want to tell you before we go live to the rest of the folks watching us online, just how thankful I am for what you've done for the program by bringing your kids to us. These are super special students. I'm really, really glad to be able to share their music live with you. You won't be able to see their faces quite as well, but they have been very heavily coached to be expressive from here to here. So watch for that. Thank you so much. The decisions that we have made as a choral program over the last 18 months have been all with safety in mind, the safety of our students, the safety of their family members back home that they're in touch with, and I'm following all protocols and studies that have come out since then, so I appreciate you being open to a slightly different scenario for a concert, but nonetheless, I think you're going to enjoy this concert. It will be under 50 minutes, which is the numbers that we've been dealing with just to make sure that we're being careful to clear the air afterwards. So we will clear out of this room pretty quickly after 50 minutes of singing. But we're going to give you 50 solid minutes here. So are you ready? Fantastic. Thanks. I'm going to leave the stage and come back, and then we'll be off and running. But again, a special welcome to all of you, and a thank you for being here today and for bringing your kids to me. My Again, thank you and welcome to our program this evening. It's a real treat to be with you. Sing a new song. And again, after 18 months, we're really excited to sing a new song for you and share a number of those. You'll find in your programs, either the ones that you have in front of you, those of you looking online, we have programs available to you digitally as well. Translations for these pieces as they come along, some of them will be within the text and some of them are at the end. And many of them are the same text that we just sang, sung in four different languages during the course of the program. So listen for that. It's efficient on the paper, too, for translation purposes there. I'd like to welcome to the stage one of my two graduate assistants. Chase Simpson is in his second year of graduate choral conducting. He comes to us from Michigan, where he did his undergraduate work at Central Michigan University and taught for a number of years up there. I have had a real good time working with my two graduate assistants this past year and a little bit, and we'd like to welcome Chase to the stage to conduct this next piece. Chase Simpson. One of my fellow West Coasters. She's from the state, great state of Oregon. She is our professor of trumpet and also director of jazz bands. Please welcome to the stage Dr. Sarah Herbert. something a little bit different. We've 3 weeks ago, I assigned this larger group into three smaller groups. And I gave them a couple of pieces of music, and I said, see you at the concert. So this is in true sense of chamber music. This is music, and I have picked the music, but the students have done all the preparation work on these on their own, which is a really important component of the program and of really kind of being professionals and being expected to handle themselves as professionals. So this is a fun challenge. They will be presenting the music, and I'm going to sit with you and listen. So without any further ado, as they're reassembling, three chamber groups and six pieces of music, enjoy. rehearsal space. For those of you that don't know, we spent all of last year rehearsing in Van Meter Auditorium, spread out 10 feet apart using the whole space of the downstairs of Van Meter, which we hope you join us at for another concert in October. But I mean, I couldn't see them, I couldn't hear them. They could kind of see me. I smiled a lot, they didn't know it. And still we made music through all that. But this year we've been back in our rehearsal space and just so grateful to do so. It's connective, this music making thing. And it's been a treat to share that with this group of people. I always, in relatively normal years, I always push for one early concert with this group. This is the end of 4 weeks of work with Labor Day in there as well. And I'm super proud of who they are and what they're doing and what they will become as the semester goes on as well. So thank you for sharing them with me again. These are neat kids. So can you give them a hand for that?
Thank you.
imagine that we're going to come in and surround you where you are, which we're not going to do today because that's not in keeping with the safety standards that we put in place. So close your eyes for a second and imagine these lovely humans walking out and surrounding you. Can you picture it? Just say yes. I believe we might have alumni here of this group. So if you're one of those people, you should probably come up at this point.
You might be the only one.
One of the absolute best parts of my job is to watch young teachers go out and teach. So this is first year teacher at Bowling Green Junior High School, the choral director, Miss Haley Cusick. Yeah. And in her first year at St. Joseph's School, Miss Lacey Mobley. Thanks again for sharing a bit of music this afternoon. and experiencing a little joy, I hope. I hope you have a great day. Thank you.